Republicans in Manhattan, so many Trump supporters in Manhattan. Does that surprise you?
No, not at all. It's turning now. Trump's turn again.
What's your message to Joe Biden?
Oh!
You saw the lips moving on that one.
Yeah, it just, oddly, there was no, he beeped, though. Right. It's crazy. Welcome back to the program. Dana Lesh here, top of second hour. I gotta tell you, those workers, dude, sometimes I'm like, did we just become best friends? I think we did. Are we best friends now? I think we are. Oh, it just warms my heart. It's hard to do. So welcome back, top of the second hour with you, Dana Lesh here. You can listen coast to coast. You can find us all over the internet. Do I got to go down the laundry list of where we're at?
It helps every now and again.
For real? Yeah. They laugh at me. Yeah. We're at X. We're at all the places where you can stream stuff. And the Facebooks and all that. We're all there. We're all there. All those places. Also find us at Substack, Chapter and Verse. And I'm on Instagram. All that. And good stuff. Good stuff. Usually it's memes and videos. That's really what it is. Because I hate doing the influencer stuff. I hate doing that. I hate doing it. Oh, it's our sales department's going to murder me. So welcome back. They're not too happy, man. Those union workers, they're in New York. They're not too happy, right? I'm just saying that if I was going to pick a kickball team, that guy would be my first pick. If I was captain,
right.
I think he'd be my first pick.
Yeah.
I think I'd be like, yeah, I want him, yeah. Let's play audio sound by 13, because this is a New York union leader, Bobby Bartels. Dang, what a New York union leader name. Like, if I had to make up a New York union leader name, I don't think I could do any better than Bobby Bartels. It's like central casting. Anyway, listen to this. Audio sound by 13.
In the past, we are basically Democrats, all of us. And after what's happened the last 4 years in this country, Democrats are basically pushing everybody to the other side. We're a very patriotic group, and we love our country, and we want the best for America. We are tired of immigration. We're tired of our tax dollars going to immigration. We're tired of the crime. We need to put a handle on things in this country and bring it back to how it should be.
The Democrats have become the party of the ultra wealthy.
Wow, these dudes. He's like, yeah, we're basically Democrats, but, you know, Democrats have pushed everybody to the other side. And he's not wrong. Democrats have decided, well, we don't want union workers and blue-collar workers anymore. What we want is Islamo-fascists and dudes who tuck. And those are going to be our two demos. You laugh, but I'm right.
Nobody wants that.
They do. They want that. That's what they want. Why? It's like a barely 1% of the... What is the matter with you? And then they want the Dearbornistan. That whole area. They want that. They want, like, the Islamo-fascist, you know, the people that did all of that. Come on. Come on. I was telling you. So that's who Democrats want. They've left the center. They've been gone for a while. I've been telling you this. Now, how do you gotta make a coalition with these people? I'm still, even with all of this, this is where I get worried. Because I know I say, don't believe the polling. And I still think you shouldn't believe the polling, because it hasn't really ever been. It wasn't right in 2016. And it also, you know, they were predicting this like giant red wave in 2020 that never manifests because Republican enthusiasm was gone. And I'm worried about what that's going to look like now going into November, because it should not be a statistical dead heat. Biden is, I think I was only alive for like a blip of Carter's presidency. But Biden seems like is he bad or worse than Carter? For the people who lived through Carter, I'm curious if they think Biden is as bad or worse than Carter. You think it's worse? You were not even an adult when Carter was president.
Adult.
You don't get an opinion in this. I'm not looking for you.
I wasn't an adult, but I sure lived through that. I remember those days.
I only want to hear from the people who were like young adults and up in Carter's presidency, because they can compare. I am fascinated as to what they think, comparing these two, what they think. I mean, no offense to everybody else, but, you know, you didn't live through it. Because I heard all these bad stories growing up, like, oh my gosh, I read Carter's biography, which was, man, he's just, I mean, everything that we have going on in the Middle East is because of Jimmy Carter. It's because of him. Biden, I will say, golly, I'm not trying to defend Carter at all. Oh, heavens no. How can I rephrase this to where it's like anything but that? Carter sounded sentient. You know what I mean? And he didn't walk like he was going to fall over on flat grass. Biden is just a horrific president. I think part of the reason why Biden's such a bad president is because he's not acting as president. I mean, he's literally not the acting president. He's not the real president. He's the figurehead. Everybody else behind the scenes, those are the people calling the shots. And it's a chaotic and it's a mess because you have a million different people running the White House instead of Joe Biden. That's why. There's no unified message. There's no consistency. There's no continuity. It's just all over chaos. And that's what happens when you have a number of people ruling in someone else's name. That's why you have it. At least Carter was consistently heinous. I mean, I will say that is Joe Biden's consistency, too. It's just the heinous decisions that are being made. But at least, you know, I don't want to say at least. Carter was aware of who he was and where he was and what he was doing and who he was talking to. But it's a mess. Absolute mess. And now you have the FCC reinstating net neutrality rules. And it's immediately being slammed, as it should be. So they voted to approve this regulation to reinstate the regulation of broadband internet access as a telecom service. They first imposed this back in 2015 under Obama, and Trump repealed it in 2017. And it's the government. It was the 3-2 vote. It's the government putting its finger on the scale. Just a mess of a decision. Thanks for watching The Dana Show. Make sure to like, subscribe, ring the bell, and stay tuned for more content.